Wendell Ford is one of three homeless men suing Concord for making them leave a makeshift camp on public property. Ford is also a convicted sex offender, required by law to verify his address at least twice a year on the state's sex offender registry, where it's listed simply as a blue and white tent.
If they're homeless, if they're living in a certain area, we ask that they put where they're living. If they're living in a vicinity near a railroad track on the south end in a blue tent, then we would put that on the form.
But Ford's information didn't contain any specific area. Scanning the list, we found several similar situations. In Concord, someone living in a blue and black tent, a van, and a car. In Manchester, the East Side and downtown parks were listed as addresses, but they didn't contain any more specific descriptions. That's a concern for victims.
When it comes to sex offenders, one of the things from a victim's perspective is knowing where they are, and it makes them much more likely, the victims, to be able to go on with their lives, knowing that somebody's monitoring that.
The city of Concord does have a designated detective who keeps track of offenders.
A detective generates a list, a random list of offenders every week, and patrol officers will go out and verify the addresses on the offenders. And that way, it's a proactive measure to ensure that the offenders are living where they say they're living.
Police say through that process, they do know where the homeless offenders are staying. If they fail to register, a warrant is issued, and that also shows up on the registry. In Concord, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.
Advocates of assault victims say after a person checks the registry for offenders in their area, they can also call local police to see if there are homeless offenders in their neighborhood.